Welcome to Rina's YouTube channel. So today we will be seeing the part 2 of our video where we are going to solve the Rubik's cube. So in this video we will particularly cover about solving the last layer of the Rubik's cube. So if you have not already watched part 1, it is there in the description box below. So in this video, as many of you have requested me about the various scenarios happening while solving your cube, I have decided to make a video to help you solve the last layer of the Rubik's cube. So now let us begin with the video. So the first scenario we will be seeing is a scenario of a straight line at the bottom of the cube. So in order to solve such a scenario, we will be using the same J technique we used to form the cross with the help of this J. So now what we are going to be doing is that for trying to make this a cross, we are going to keep this line vertical and we are going to use the same J technique we used earlier. So there we go. We get a J. After this, we can solve the cube just as we normally do. So then the next scenario we will be undergoing will be the corners scenario. So in this scenario, we will get one corner piece that is adjusted to its surroundings, but all the other three are completely in their random positions. So let me show you how to solve this kind of a scenario. So now we'll keep the solved part or the solved corner to our left hand side, and then we'll keep the remaining on our right hand side and the unsolved other corner piece on the bottom of our left hand side. So what we are going to do is that we are going to use an L11 technique we used earlier to place the corners in their right position. So first, in order to perform the 11 technique, we are going to move this the right side in an anti-clockwise direction, and then we are going to move the bottom to clockwise direction, and then we are going to move the left side to clockwise direction, and then the bottom to anti-clockwise, and then we are just like, you know, replacing the formula. So now we have got this, but all the other pieces are still scattered, but they are all different places. Now we want this to move here, and this to move here, and this to move here. So in order to do that, we are repeating the same technique we used. So now the cube is solved. But if you don't get the cube solved and only two parts of the cube are solved for you, we will be discussing that part in the next step. So in this scenario, we will be getting two corner pieces at their right position, but the other two will be either flipped or in their wrong position. So in order to correct something like these, we must use the corner technique we used earlier. So in order to use the corner technique, we are going to turn the right side anti-clockwise, the bottom twice clockwise, and then we are going to lift it anti-clockwise, and then we are going to turn the bottom clockwise again, and then we are going to just turn this back and put it in that position. We are going to repeat the same but inverse in the other direction. So you will either get the cube solved now, or they will be again flipped, but their positions change. So what we are going to do now is that we are going to repeat the same technique again. So now our cube is solved. So the next technique we will be using will cover this and this. They both will be in their right position, but the opposite sides will make the problem. So in order to discuss that, please watch the video continuously. So this is the video where we get a situation like this. The opposite two sides match each other, but the other opposite sides have a problem with matching them. So in order to fix like something like this, the first formula we use is the corner formula. But we are also going to do it in the opposite side. Now we will get something like this. Just don't change any side and just keep this side in your left hand side. And just repeat the same step again. Now we have got something like this. So you all know how to solve it further, but let me show you it again. same method. Okay, so now let us do the same step again. And there we go. The cube is solved. Thanks for watching, guys. If you really find my videos helpful, please like the video and press the subscribe button. If you want to know more about cubing, please subscribe to our channel and also press the bell icon to keep you notified. So hope you enjoy the video. Please comment and share our video. Thank you.